I am a child of modern India. Independent, self-reliant, one of the world's fastest growing economies. A population of over 1.2 billion people, 72% of whom live in villages across the country, inhabiting a space we often call Bharat, traditional, agricultural, rural. Sadly, people here do not share the fruits of development, but wrestle with issues of poverty, hunger, malnutrition, and illiteracy. Surely this was not the dream of our founding fathers, this ever-widening chasm between haves and have-nots? Cannot urban, industrial India offer a suitable solution to its fellow citizens to earn a livelihood and live a decent life? I hear about a revolutionary act that is being implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development from 2006. The Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act that promises 100 days of work to any rural household whose adult members are willing to do unskilled manual labor. Each household needs to register for a job card first and then file an application for work. Within 15 days of applying, work has to be allocated to that family, failing which, an unemployment allowance is to be paid. And in most states, the wages paid are not below the minimum wages of that state. Could this be the answer I am looking for?
The Employment Guarantee Act is the most significant legislation of our times. In many ways, it is a legal right to livelihood, a right the people can demand to be enforced. The Act gives employment, it gives income, it gives a livelihood, and gives a chance for all to live a life of self-respect and dignity. The Employment Guarantee Act transfers power in the hand of our people.
An act groundbreaking in its intent and framework. However, 5 years into its implementation, has Mahatma Gandhi Narega made any difference to Bharat? We embark on a journey to four different states in India to explore the implementation of the Act and its impact on the rural poor. Rajasthan is an eye-opener. Known for its arid and barren landscapes, water has been a perennial problem here. But thanks to the projects undertaken by the Mahatma Gandhi Narega scheme, water bodies have been created, water tables restored, resulting in greenery all around. Am I still in Rajasthan? The Vijaipura constituency is also credited with introducing the concept of wall painting all accounts of the project, so as to ensure complete transparency and accountability. Leading this movement has been Kalu Ram, a model sarpanch, the democratically elected head of the village panchayat, which is the local self-governing body.
Kenari ji has revitalized the notion of the panchayat because the panchayat has become the basis for all this. So whether it's dysfunctioning, whether it's malfunctioning, whether there's malevolence, whatever there may be in the panchayat has become a focus. It is now not a non-issue, it's an issue. So it is focused on the panchayat as a delivery mechanism, as a decision-making mechanism, as a political entity. It has taken the concept of transparency to the smallest village in this country.
Questions racing through my head, we move our trail to Bihar in the east, where almost 85% of the population lives in villages. Improved governance by the current state government has led to an economic revival here.
A lot of the migration from India to happens from Bihar, and these are people who are going in search of work. What NREGA helps is people who migrate out of no choice by offering an alternative employment closer to home, and therefore the compromise they have to make with their life because of this long separation from home and the sort of the consequences of distress migration, this helps to alleviate that.
We need large-scale works. The entire Kosi Canal system is being rejuvenated. To ensure that the 100 days entitlement reaches the people, it has to open large-scale works, which means that it should link with these departments, which is a provision in NREGA, that convergence provision with other departments. If that happens, we would see, I think that would really transform the face of Bihar and especially its workers.
Har kadam par ladai lena padta hai, har kadam par uske saath bhidan dena padta hai. तब हम लोगों को रोजगार का जो है एक मिलता है तो एक तरफ हम कहते हैं दीदी कि एक तरफ सरकार एक मनरेगा कानून बना दिए उसके लिए अलग एक विभाग निकाल दिए हैं और मेरा बात कहीं सुना नहीं जा रहा है तो फिर हम क्या करेंगे
द ट्रेमेंडस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल पोटेंशियल ऑफ NREGA हाउएवर इज बीइंग कैन बी सीन इन वन सिंपल वे व्हिच इज दैट इट्स हेल्पिंग लेबर टू ऑर्गेनाइज इटसेल्फ No matter how small the NREGA works may be in an area, the fact is that they do have a choice to say that this is the wage that we are getting. For example, it is 114 right now, the minimum wages, which is not paid in agriculture work. So, but that wage itself has increased because people now have a choice.
To me, the biggest thing that NREGA delivers is an entitlement, based on which the citizen can question the state, interrogate the state as equal, saying that here is my entitlement, why have you not delivered? So there is a certain citizenship, quality of citizenship improves. For me, that's the biggest thing that NREGA delivers. The Bihar I saw in 1985 is not the Bihar I see today. The power relationships have changed. Once people get a basic level of income, then they're able to stand up for their rights and talk to the rest as equals, not near equals, but approaching equality.
Absolutely, there are processes. I think a combination of both the right to information and the NREGA give an indication of how basic power structures can actually be shaken up. If you provide just fundamental things which our constitution says you should be providing, without you're having to use force and without a bloody revolution, people have actually gained bargaining power. And for the first time, this government system is being made to answer. We need to learn actually from people's efforts in NREGA because they are showing us what has gone wrong in this structure, what can be made to correct it, and they're doing it every day and in millions of places across the country. And that's a democratic change or radical change within a democracy.
वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे पीड़ पराई जाने रे वैष्णव जन तो तेने कहिए जे वचन तो ये ने कही जे पीड़ पराई